Hello everybody, and welcome to White Hart Gaming as we start a brand new playthrough, this one of Farthest Frontier. This is going to be the new content, which should be coming out on Tuesdays. I've got one simulation, which obviously is the House of Wessex playthrough. And I've got one RPG in terms of Baldur's Gate 3. So this is going to be the city builder. I've not played Farthest Frontier for some months. There's been updates and things, so there have been some things that have probably changed. And I'm just going to go into it and see what I remember and what brand new I can pick up. And obviously I probably have forgotten some things as well. So let's start a new settlement. Naturally, can delete the first letter. I'm going to call it White Hart. Go for medium. Go to advanced settings. To go here into Pioneer. And maybe go down here. I want to focus on the city building aspect rather than the defending aspect. But I think I'll leave everything but Raiders at average. Train. I think I'll leave Idyllic Valley as well. Random map seed, so let's see what we get. And just before we do that, just want to make sure I turn stuff down. I have okay. Alright, let's start.
Class would still collect the same share, leaving our children to starve. And if we had any coin to our name, the taxman would appear, demanding it for the crown. The nobles hid behind the safety of their walls and did nothing when raiders pillaged the outskirts of the city. And so, some of us decided that it was time to leave. We'd rather take our chances in the wilderness, seeking the promise of a new land, than starve to death in our homeland. The journey wasn't easy. We lost many along the way. But this wild, unsettled land offers us the hope of a new start, as the masters of our own destiny.
Okay, so we've finished scouting the surrounding area, survey the land your villagers have explored and choose a promising site to construct your town centre. It's important to choose a location that's near the resources you'll need to build a successful settlement. Things like clay, iron ore, and potential food sources. Okay. So let's zoom out. So we're on a mountain here. Basically in a valley between two mountains. We do have a lake nearby. Okay. I'm just taking a look around to see. There's some food there. Food here. Actually here. Kind of this area here maybe might be a good idea. But I don't want to have to clear away a load of stuff to get it done. Turn around. I don't think all materials need to be in use, but I think there is going to be best. Just want to say, guys, I've got a bit of a sore throat at the moment, so if I sound a bit scratchy or a lot of throat clearing going on, then that's why. It always starts when these games start with a housing shortage. I move you just a little bit out the way. And housing. I think we have to actually build the town center before that unlocks, so I'm just gonna speed up time. Have 11 logs, we need 16. How do I harvest resources? There we go. Get rid of these trees immediately around the area. And now housing should be available, yeah. Predator attack in. Get it. Stamp. Four houses. That's where four houses gets us. And just as a basic food, I'm going to get the fish and shack. We can get is two and more fish along here. Nope. Swim. So 9, 8. There's 9, so that seems like the best place for it. Deep iron deposit. Deer sighted. It's right here. It's berries, mushrooms, nuts. So that's because we've run out of wood, so let's come up. So, got resources, so I'm gonna harvest those there. Okay, just gonna pause. So we need firewood and water. Firewood splitter. And a well as well. Seems good. We need stone for that, so three stone around here. Yep. It's not the best place for a forager shed, because it's only going to be collecting one thing. Get somewhere where there's going to be the mushrooms and the greens, but doesn't look like there is. Really, do you want the village to kind of develop into this area here? At least initially. Just clear some of the smaller things now. The roots. I need a smokehouse, if I remember correctly. Yep. Kind of there in that junction there, kind of seems like the most obvious place. Next to the fish and next to the firewood. Explore a little bit. does appear to be wolves around, so just gonna be careful. Not gonna ask them to go to those stupid places. Exactly why I didn't want to do that. There we go. Going away. Go away. Well, I probably need storage actually. Stockyard. Fish. Let's see what we've got. Mushrooms, nuts, we've got some greens, smoked fish, smoked meat. So why do all these houses say there's wells? It's close enough to get water, but this one doesn't. So we produced 268, we consumed 216, spoiled was 23. We're consuming more vegetables than we consumed. Fruit, we produced more than we consumed, so. And the cellar is what I wanted, the root cellar. Got fed with dysentery. rains it pours. Get that. I think villagers do heal if they've been attacked. So we've already got those tagged for stone removal. Oh no. Poor lady. Now, I'm not sure, but if we just have a graveyard. We just have a graveyard like normal. Here against the river? Or the lake, rather. This is a small one. Extremely frustrating. Where is it? Resources. Right behind the bloody house. So that does create a thing for the body to be picked up. Rabies is from the bite. He's a goner, basically. Jesus H. Christ. Yep, a wolf den nearby, that's why. Yep. I'm gonna be dead of bloody wolf attacks before I get anywhere. I think we've had, what, 4 die already? So up here we have 10 months of food in public storage and we have 4 ritual spoil. So we have 6 months of food basically, that's what that means. Tempted to put down a hunter's capping here. There's no deer, but just gonna put a road in, I think, as well. Thank you. Got another fish sauce there. So I could put some more fish down. We have a very protein heavy diet, I feel, initially. There's going to be a photo mode, because that might make a good screenshot for the just going to pause. That might make a doesn't seem like it. Some of it was in the water, so it's now been moved. Can't see any boar, but seven months and zero spoilage, so I hope that means things are going in the right direction. Get out! Boo! Kill Bambi! There! Some more exploration just around the area. got something. Lucky I had something. But it didn't say anything had been produced. So there's the boar. Yay! So a boar carcass is going to give us 200 meat, 3 pelts, and 4 tallow, if I'm understanding that correctly. Just gonna mute guys, just so I can have a drink. So we definitely had something. The boar carcass is gone. But it seems like we're just dealing with carcass as normal, is what that looked like. Some of it already got smoked. Feel secure enough to add on another house. I think we're gonna now create a side street. Let's take a one, two. Create a dirt road, just go down. So this definitely seems to be a meat issue rather than a firewood issue, because we've got plenty of firewood. put this house this way for some more people to move in. Then I'll construct a second fishing shack down here. Gone into the mountain there, guys. Gonna work out a good screenshot. Maybe like that with the town centre. But I think having this is more picturesque. Kind of a shack in the woods, surrounded by the nice foliage. I'll have to decide. Why are you unable to work? Explain. Let's go with fashions. One bites dust. I closer. Turning away for now. Run. Keeps happening. No. 24. Okay, guys. My voice is actually kind of struggling, so just make sure that actually did save, sorry. Yes, it did. So I'm just gonna save just to be on the safe side. Call it a day there. If you want to see how this develops and see if I can actually get a good village and not have everyone die of starvation, then just remember to like, comment, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to keep updated with this latest series. Until next time, this was White Hart Gaming. And until next time, thank you very much. Goodbye, everybody.